Powerwall 3 expansion units are added to Powerwall 3 systems to increase the overall energy storage capacity of the system. Like Powerwall 3, expansion units store 13.5 kilowatt hours of energy, but they have neither AC nor DC terminals within the enclosure. Instead, they are daisy-chained into the circuit for Powerwall 3 with a custom wiring harness, plugged into this port on either left or right side of the unit. Powerwall 3 expansion units are nearly identical to Powerwall 3. The height and width are the same, but the footprint is slightly thinner than Powerwall. Expansion units have two mounting options. They can be stacked in groups of up to 4 units when floor-mounted, or mounted to the wall adjacent to Powerwall 3. Expansion units can be ordered with either a wall mounting kit or a stacking kit. This video focuses on how to mount expansion units next to Powerwall 3. For more information about how to stack expansion units, refer to the installation manual or watch the video titled Powerwall Expansion Unit Stacking. The wall mounting kit includes a mounting bracket, 9 harness straps, the front cover, and 6 front cover screws. To mount an expansion, follow the same steps used to mount Powerwall 3, which starts with determining the mounting bracket location. For units that will be at ground level, measure this distance up from the floor for the top row of fasteners. Mount the bracket to at least 2 suitable structural members, using at least 4 fasteners, and ensure that the bracket is both level and securely attached to the wall. Use Powerwall Dolly to position the Powerwall 3 expansion so the mounting cleats are just above the flanges on the bracket. Lower the unit until both the upper and lower sets of cleats engage the flanges on the bracket. Visually confirm that all 4 cleats are engaged on the mounting bracket before proceeding. Adjust the leveling feet to account for any uneven surfaces. Repeat these steps to mount Powerwall 3 and any other Powerwall expansions. The wiring harness for Powerwall expansion units is available in multiple lengths to accommodate units mounted in various configurations. Use a harness with a length that allows for proper strapping without putting tension on the connectors. Access the expansion port by using a T40 driver to remove this screw and then remove the expansion port cover. It is normal to hear the unit depressurizing during this step. Caution: do not remove this cover if exposed to active rain or snow. To prevent damage or debris, do not remove the protective cover from the wiring harness or expansion port cover until ready to make connections. Remove the protective cover and plug the wiring harness into the expansion port. When fully seated in the expansion port, the rubber gasket around the connector will not be visible. Secure the connector to the port with the T40 screw and torque as specified. Route the other end of the wiring harness to the next unit, either another expansion or Powerwall 3. Connect the other end of the wiring harness to the next unit and secure it with a T40 screw, tightening to the specified torque value. If a wiring harness is dropped or otherwise damaged, dispose of it and use a new harness. For side-by-side mounting installations, make the most symmetrical harness runs by identifying the middle point of the harness and marking it with a pencil or piece of tape. Mark the wall at the center line between the 2 Powerwall units. Use a 1-hole strap to secure the middle point of the harness at the center mark on the wall. Bridgeport US6171 straps, included with the expansion unit, must be used to strap Powerwall expansion harnesses. Evenly bend the harness on both sides of this strap to create matching bends that comply with the allowable bend radius. Secure the harness with additional straps as required by code. A strap should be placed no further than this distance from the connector on each end. With all Powerwall 3 expansion units connected, turn on the breaker and the Powerwall 3 enable switch. Proceed with the standard commissioning procedure performed through the leader Powerwall 3. On the devices page, verify that all Powerwall expansion units are detected and present in the list. If an update is available, tap Update Expansion and wait for it to complete. Continue with the standard procedure to finish commissioning, including starting the system, performing a backup test, and completing the customer registration. Installers can confirm the connected Powerwall expansions on the summary page. The final step is to install the glass front covers, please consult the Powerwall 3 Finishing the Install video and the installation manual for details.